book Billy Allsbrooks to speak at your next event. Call 407-310-3275. Warning! Videos by Billy Allsbrooks do cause side effects. And those side effects are champions being born, dreams being realized, the weak becoming strong, weight loss, victory over unbelievable odds, incredible comeback stories, the sick being healed, marriages being restored, victory over all forms of addiction, job promotions, average people becoming millionaires, warriors becoming blessed and unstoppable. These videos will motivate and inspire you to take action. Warning, your faith is now being increased to the level it takes to move mountains.
Rise.
Arise, champion. I'm Billy Allsbrooks and I approve this message. Beautiful disaster, preparation for the calling, alone and lost, anthem of the fallen, fire truth music, you gotta trust me, success is a romance, prove that you love me, the voice that keeps on calling, destiny hugging me, the shadows of past mistakes, the waiting it bugs me, at war with average, ruthless and demanding, by any righteous means necessary, I'm still standing, a masterpiece of grace, the whisper of failure, don't buy the lies that doubt is trying to sell you, reframe the perspective, embrace the process, a gorgeous mess, your faith the litmus test, colorful stepping stones, you're not alone, breathing hours for hours, take me home, follow the smoke, life is a journey, fire, truth, music, breathe, keep burning, the power makes you feel alive, illuminate the world with that gift you have on the inside, hands restrained, signs sealed and delivered with rain, take it off like a plane, your whole world is about to change, money, power, fame, the journey to finding your name, the closest around you will be last to see the change, against the grain, the one they call strange, those around you will be the last to see the change, beautiful, strong and amazing, fire, truth, music, keep blazing, day six, your time is coming. A few weeks ago, I got booked to speak at this amazing college. But this college was literally out in the middle of nowhere. My hotel's an hour away. So on the day of the event, I go down to my car and I put the address of the college into my GPS and I begin my journey. And as soon as I get away from the exit where my hotel is, I do not pass another car, another business, or a house for 50 miles from there all the way onto the campus. Even when I get to the college ground, there's nothing around there. The road just leads me right up to the college. The security guard opens the gate and then I drive onto this beautiful campus. See, I remember on the way there, beginning to doubt my own GPS, like, cause there was nothing on the left, nothing on the right, just country as far as you could see. And I'm like, this can't be where I'm going. There's, you know, the GPS says I'm on the right track, but everything I'm seeing with my eyes does not reflect what the GPS is saying. But something moved on my spirit in that moment and said, this is symbolic for life. That place you came from, that hotel you were just at with all the surrounding stuff, that was the comfort zone. And where you are going is the dream, the final destination in the GPS is the vision that you've been holding in your mind for so long. But along that journey, you will have to have faith to believe. Even when you don't see anything to the left or to the right or to the front or to the back of you, you just have to keep going and trusting and believing in that vision that you're holding in your mind. Just like the college had booked me to speak at that location, at that destination, destiny has booked you for success, has booked you for victory, has booked you for overcoming, for healing, for everything that you have in your mind, anything that you can believe for, destiny will stand by you. Those who cannot overcome their physical eyes disqualify themselves from success. You have to master the art of blindness and stop seeing things as they are and start dreaming of what they could be, can be, and will be when you water that dream with grind. Just like I was alone on that road for 50 miles with not another car, a house, a business along that path. Sometimes you will have to take the journey to success, the journey to finding yourself, the journey to destiny. Sometimes you have to do it alone. The greater the size of the dream, the less those around you will understand it. But don't let them stop you from finding you. Don't let them rob you of greatness. Don't let them steal your destiny. The truth is, 99% of the people around you are local. And if you have global ambitions, when you start speaking big dreams to these people, it's gonna be like you're speaking Chinese. They are not gonna understand you. Expect this from them, and don't let it discourage you. When you dream, dream massive. All dreams give birth to lukewarm people, and the only people that wanna be around lukewarm people are more lukewarm people. The day you start reaching, striving, and stretching for what the world says is impossible is the first day that you start living. Here's how I measure my dream to see if I'm dreaming big enough. I find average, everyday people, and I sit down with them and I tell them my dream. If they tell me I can do it, then I know I'm dreaming too small. I go back to the drawing board and I dream massive until those average, everyday people tell me I'm crazy. Then I plant my flag down in the dirt and I get to work and I do what the world says is impossible. Now I know a lot of you out there listening to me right now are seeking to find yourself. You're empty on the inside because you know you were meant for something greater than your life is reflecting right now. I get that. See, 3 months before my dad died in 2007, I retired from rapping. Up until that point, for 17 years, I had a clear vision for my life. Every day I got up with a purpose and knew exactly what I was working towards. My life was consolidated. I had one mind, one dream, one goal that I got up every day and aggressively pursued. But that season was over, and now my life had this big, huge void. I had lost my identity. The world knew me as the rapper. But now that I'm no longer rapping, who am I? For 10 years, I went on this journey seeking to find myself. The greatest success in life is to discover yourself, to discover you, to discover your own truth that God planted in you, for you to walk in the fullness of the power, the blessing, the victory that God has given you. First, you must become self-aware. Until you become aligned with what God has made you to be, you will continue to struggle. The purpose of that struggle is to move you from where you are to where you are supposed to be. If you were comfortable, you would be content and you would never leave. Therefore, you would never walk in the fullness of the blessing and receive all the things that God wants you to receive. Hear me out. God has a plan for you. And every night, I go on a prayer walk, praying to God. And for 10 years during this wilderness season of not knowing who I was, I used to go out there every single night and throw my hands up to the sky and I'd say, Lord, who did you make me to be? Who am I? What is my calling? What am I missing? Why am I struggling? Something is wrong. Show me what it is. Peace by peace, he began to reveal to me who I was and what he had planned for me. It wasn't an overnight thing. Every so often along this journey, I would get this little piece, this little revelation of me, and I'd have to walk that piece out in faith in order to get the next piece. Now, some of you out there listening to me right now are waiting for full revelation before you begin to move. You won't take a step until you know exactly what the end result is gonna be. You're never gonna find it that way, because that way doesn't require faith. It's impossible to please him without faith. So you're gonna have to step out into the unknown with that little piece that he gives you. You see, you don't need the end piece. All you need is the next piece. The next piece will bring you to the next piece, and that piece to the next piece until you get to the end. Your true calling for your life will always be attached to fire. The things that you are most passionate about are clues to the things that you have been assigned to do here on earth. The key to finding yourself is following the smoke. Where there is smoke, there is fire. And where the fire is, you are, and God is. Success requires vibrating at a higher level. In order to get to that level, you need energy, and that energy is found in your passion. If you're trying to find yourself, you have to fully examine your life. Think back as far as you can think. There are clues from day one pointing you to you. When I was 6 years old, my mother and father went Amway, and they used to bring me to these big conventions and seminars that they used to have all over the United States. I used to bring my little tape recorder with me that I had gotten for Christmas. and I'd be sitting there with the record button on, listening to some of the greatest motivational speakers to ever walk a stage. See, I was being groomed way back then for what I'm doing now. Now, I had a studio in my house for years when I was doing the rapping. And when I retired, I just left it there. The mic was in the center of the room, and I never moved it. Every night, when I'd go out to do my prayer walk, as I mentioned before, I'd walk right by that microphone. I'd go out there and do my hour prayer time, come back inside and have to walk right by that mic again on the way to the bedroom. I went out there for years asking God, what is my calling? What have you assigned me to do? What is my gift? Why are you not helping me? Why are you not pointing to me? And every night I'd walk inside and walk right by the thing God had assigned me to do. It was right in front of me. Now I ask you, what are you missing? What is your microphone? Sometimes you is right in front of you. There's an old saying, you can't see the forest for the trees. And it's the same with life. Sometimes life is screaming so loud at us that we can't hear it. Everything that you have been looking for is right in front of you. Everything that you need to fulfill your destiny is on the inside of you. God has equipped you already for everything you need to succeed in life. Follow the smoke until you find yourself. Fire truth music. You're closer than you think. Arise, champion. This is Billy Allsbrooks, and I am blessed and unstoppable. And to God be the glory. Truth is the new black, the couture for greatness. Get your t-shirts now at blessedandunstoppable.com. Join the movement. There was a 7-year-old boy on his knees praying before bedtime. And as he began to close his eyes, he was brought up into heaven. And when he got there, all he could see was miles and miles and miles of warehouses. And filled with curiosity, he asked God, "What's in those buildings?" God smiled and said, "Come, let's see." And as he and God walked through the massive doors and entered these buildings, all he could see were storage units and huge containers, each one having a name on it that he recognized. He saw his little brother's name, his little sister's name, his mother's name, his father's name, his uncle's name, his cousin's name, his classmates' names, his teacher's names, all the people at church. He saw all the names on these containers. So he asked God, "What's in there?" God smiled and said, "Come, let's see." He took the little boy by the hand and walked over to the containers and one by one began opening them. And he said, "Son, these are all the gifts, blessings, victories, breakthroughs, healing, happiness, peace, and abundance that I want to give to my people if they would just believe. Go back home, son, and tell them all that I have for them. Tell them just how much I love them and that with me, all things are possible because I, God, will never, ever, ever fail my people. All I ask of them is to believe. Truly, I tell you, if anyone says to this mountain, 'Go, throw yourself into the sea,' and does not doubt in their heart, but believes that what they say will happen, it will be done for them. Religion won't change your life, but faith will. Our objective is not to have faith, it's to become it. God still moves mountains. Faith is oxygen. Don't let your dreams suffocate. Anything outside the promises of God is just a temporary illusion. I dare you to believe. Faith is your weapon. And it's time for us as believers to go to war. Now I want to clear something up. Hoping and wishing ain't the same thing as trusting God. There's three kinds of faith: hope, faith, and trust. Now, hope is, I hope there's a God up there. I hope he has the power to change the world. I hope he loves me enough to intervene on my behalf. Then there's faith, the next level. And faith is, I believe there's a God up there. And I believe, I have faith that he has power to change the world. But I hope that he loves me enough to intervene on my behalf. 99% of the church body as a whole resides in the first two levels of faith, hope and faith. This is why the church today is functioning in limited power. Now the third level is trust. And this is where the power's at. Trust is, I know there's a God up there. I know he has the power to change the world. I know he loves me enough because he's done his son for me. And I know he will not fail me, and he will intervene on my behalf. And I trust him enough to step out and do something. This kind of trust is what got Peter out of the boat. There were 12 disciples there with God, but only one trusted him enough to get out of the boat and to walk on that water. And it's no coincidence that God chose to build his church on the rock. Peter, it's time to stop wishing, hoping, and crossing our fingers that God is gonna do something. It's time to start trusting and believing in the one we serve. Prayer without expectation is not a prayer, it's a wish. It's not the length of your prayer that gives it power. It's the faith behind it. Your focus is hindering God's power. Stop focusing on your problem and focus on the God to which all things bow. Church is not some place that we go. It's something that we are. It's not a location. It's not a building. It's a mindset, a lifestyle. God did not design you to be comfortable. He designed you to conquer. And to do that, you gotta get out of the comfort zone. You gotta stretch. You gotta reach. You gotta strive for greatness. Dare to believe all things are possible. God has given you the promised land, but the only way you're gonna enter it is by faith. You gotta seize the moment. You gotta conquer the day. For the Lord did not give us the spirit of fear, but of power and of love and of sound mind. Don't let doubt downsize God's plan for your life. From this point forward, pray only one-time prayers. Whatever your need is, go to God's word and find out what it says. And then you stand on what that word says. So when you pray, you ask God one time. And then from that moment forward, you believe that prayer is answered. Don't pray it again, because if you pray it twice, the enemy's gonna think you didn't believe what you prayed for the first time. The enemy can't read your mind, but he can hear your words. And he can smell fear, and he can smell doubt. That's like blood to a shark to him. It's time for believers to start believing. We gotta stop serving our emotions and start serving God. Real faith is never subject to circumstances. It's unconditional. Faith is more than words. It's an unconditional activity, a continuous action of refusing to concede or accept one's current circumstances. The only outcome I will accept is the one that God promised. You have to authorize God to do the impossible. Your faith grants that authorization. Go get your victory. Dreams bloom in the fertile soil of expectation. I dare you to believe. Your eyes were designed to see the visible. Faith allows you to see the invisible, what's to come, to peer into the future. Destiny is obligated by universal law to concede to the demands of unwavering faith. No matter where you are or what your circumstance is, faith will bend and shape reality in order to bring heaven to you. As believers, we're supposed to be pro-life, but everyday Christians are committing abortions. And what I mean by that is every time you give up on a dream, every time you doubt God, you commit abortion. portion on a life that you could have had. Every ounce of your being, everything on the outside of you, all the people around you might be saying what you're trying to do is impossible. But with God, all things are possible. If you really want to change your life, you take Matthew 19:26. With God, all things are possible. And you make that the foundation of your existence. Because the faith that pleases God is the faith that pursues doing the impossible. Because that gives God an opportunity to shine. I'm Billy Osbrooks, blessed and unstoppable. And as always, to God be the glory. Blessed and unstoppable. Success starts with putting the right things into your mind. And my new book, Blessed and Unstoppable, was strategically designed to align your mind with the laws of success. This curriculum will teach you the inner mechanics required to go from average to phenomenal, from living a life with limits to being blessed and unstoppable. As you follow this guide step by step, amazing breakthroughs will happen. New doors of opportunity will open, and favor will begin to chase you down. Blessed and Unstoppable is a 31-day devotional on the laws of success. This book will instigate the thought process and actions required to transform your life. Each day has a Bible verse, a teaching on that day's principle, a positive affirmation, a prayer for the day, self-assessment questions, success quotes, action steps, and a powerful inspirational message. Regardless of what field you're in, Blessed and Unstoppable is your blueprint for success. Get your copy at blessedandunstoppable.com. Also available on Amazon.